Our next topic is osmosis. What is mean by osmosis? Osmosis is a movement of solvent or water molecule from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration through semi-permeable membrane. So osmosis is the movement of solvent or water, right? Solvent or water. Here we can use water, okay? So it is permeable. It allows the water, right? So it is permeable, okay? Then from the region of higher concentration. This one is a higher concentration. Higher concentration towards the lower concentration. This one is called as a lower concentration. Higher concentration towards the lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Consider this cotton as a semi-permeable membrane. See here also some water is there, right? So semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis is the movement of solvent or water from the region of higher concentration towards the lower concentration through the semi-permeable membrane. This process is continuously doing when the equilibrium is reached. When the factor reaches the equilibrium, still that the process is done. So the equilibrium, that word is new word, no? So what is mean by equilibrium? A state of balance, especially between the force or influence that are working in opposite ways. Working in opposite ways, state of balance, especially between the force or influence that are working in the opposite ways, okay? That one is called as a... So, osmosis is a movement of solvent or water or molecule from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration through the semi-permeable membrane. This process is carried out till an equilibrium is reached. Osmosis is a passive movement. What is mean by passive movement? Passive process means substance that pass through the without any energy input. So, here no energy input. There. Then next one is type of osmosis. First you know the definition of osmosis. Next one is the types of osmosis. One is plasmolysis, another one is imbibition. One is plasmolysis and another one is imbibition. Okay, so plasmolysis, it occurs when water moves out of the cell and resulting in the shrinkage of the cell membrane. Here many leaves are there. What is the difference between this leaf and this leaf? This is also aloe vera and this is also aloe vera. So here plasmolysis is done. How we notice here plasmolysis is done? So what is the definition of plasmolysis? Plasmolysis means when water moves out of the cell. So this one is a aloe vera. This one is also aloe vera. But only the difference, it's having water, it's not having the water, okay? It occurs when water moves out of the cell, okay? Resulting in the shrinkage of the cell membrane. This cell membrane shrinkage. What is the meaning of shrinkage? Churungi irukku illaya. So, see, this is the aloe vera. See, the leaves, reduced leaves is there. Okay, but the water out means it is nothing, okay? So shrinkage of water, okay? You can see the difference between these two. This is a fresh plant, okay? And this is not a fresh plant, okay? See the condition of leaf here. See the condition of leaf, okay? This is a fresh plant. So here slowly the water is come out from the cell. I'm not sure the full water is came out. Slowly the water came out. So, see the difference between these two plants. This is all the same plant. But only the difference here, water is comes out. Slowly water is comes out. Here, fully water content is there. So, it's become very fresh, right? It's not fresh one, okay? So, as soon as possible, it will fully shrink, okay? Like this. So this one is called as a plasmolysis. It occurs when water moves out the cell as result in the shrinkage of the cell membrane. Okay, next one is imbibition. What is the difference between the plasmolysis and imbibition? Okay, this is also the type of diffusion. Okay, yeah. Plasmolysis also type of, sorry, plasmolysis is a type of osmosis, and imbibition is also type of the osmosis and diffusion. Okay, so what is mean by diffusion? You know that the movement of molecule or liquid solid from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration without utilization of energy is called as a diffusion. Here also no energy. So imbibition is a type of diffusion in which a solid absorb water and gets swallowed up. Okay, solid absorb water and gets swallowed up. Okay, for imbibition I can add one video. Okay, so absorption of water by seeds and dry grapes. Okay, so see what is this? This is the onion plant, right? Absorption of water by seeds. This one is a seed. So water is absorbed by this seed and grow well, right? So this is imbibition. If we were not for imbibition, the seeds would not have been able to emerge out of the soil. Soil ka mele edala vara mudiyadu, seeds ala, sorry, and the young plant ala vara mudiyadu. If it is were not for imbibition nadakalana, so seedlings would not have been able to emerge out of the cell. Okay. Thank you, children. Here I can add some notes for better understanding. Here I send few questions. You can able to answer means you can understand this portion. Already I said no. I can add one video for the imbibition. So that video is this one is that video. In example of imbibition, dry grapes. No. So I can add some oil and some dry grapes, so it will swell up. You can see the difference between the normal dry grapes and this grapes. Thank you, students.